we will study net present value and internal rate of return. We also have few example problems at the end of the lesson. Let's get started. We studied the concept of present value and future value in our previous lesson. Present value tells us how much is our money worth today. The future value is the value of money in the future. Mathematically, here, N is the number of time periods. R is the rate of return per time period. FVN represents future value after N time periods. PV is the present value. The concept of net present value is based on this formula. We are considering a project that will last 3 years. We have to buy some equipment immediately. This will cost $1,000. This is a cash outflow. We call this negative cash flow. We use the minus sign to indicate the outflow. In the next year, there is an additional cost worth $400. So, minus 400 is a negative cash flow. In the same year, we also expect a revenue of $200. It is a gain, an inflow of cash. We call this positive cash flow, plus 200 in year 1. We have only positive cash flows for year 2 and year 3. Next, we will find the net cash flow, the total cash flow at a given point of time. For time 0, positive cash flow is 0. So, net cash flow is 0 plus minus 1000 or minus $1,000. Similarly, we have minus $200 net cash flow for year 1, plus 1,500 for year 2, and plus $1,000 for year 3. The time value of money is not yet captured. How do we do that? We will find the present value of these cash flows. For this, we need the rate of return. It is 10% per annum. Our net cash flow at time 0 is minus 1000. The present value is also minus 1000. For year 1, the present value will be minus 182. I have rounded off the numbers to the nearest integer. For the year 2, the present value of net cash flow is plus 1240. Finally, for year 3, the present value is plus 751. Let's add all these numbers. We get plus 809. This is the net present value of this project. It is positive. We will be making money with our investment on this project. The rule is simple. All projects with positive NPV should be undertaken. Negative or zero NPV should not be done. This technique to find the net present value is called discounted cash flow analysis or the DCF. Rate of return is also sometimes called discount rate. Next, we will look at IRR or internal rate of return. Internal rate of return can be described as an extension of net present value. This is a generic formula that has net cash flows from time period 0 to time period n. Rate of return per period is given to us. But for IRR, we take a different approach. IRR is actually the inherent rate of return for a set of cash flows. When rate of return R equals IRR, the net present value is 0. We replace R with IRR and NPV with 0 to get. If we know the net cash flows, we can use this equation to calculate IRR. Not an easy equation to solve. Don't worry, the PMP exam will never ask you to solve for IRR. Still, for the sake of completion, let's try to find the IRR for the cash flows in our previous example. NPV is 0, and the net cash flows are minus 1000 for year 0, minus 200 for year 1, plus 1500 for year 2, and plus 1000 for year 3. I used Excel to get the IRR as 39.3%. Now, how do we use IRR for project selection? Target IRR is defined for the projects. Let us assume that the target IRR for this project was 20%. The actual is 39.3%, greater than the target of 20%. This means we are good to go ahead with the project. If the actual IRR was less than the target of 20%, we would have rejected the project. Actual IRR has to be higher than the target IRR for project selection. Next, let us try a few problems. This is our first problem. Project A has NPV of $100K and will take 6 months to complete. Project B has NPV of $120K and will take 1 year to complete. Duration of Project C and Project D is 2 years. Project C has NPV of $110K and Project D has NPV of $128K. You have to select one of these projects. Which one will you pick? There are 4 choices. A. Project A. B. Project B. C. Project C. D. Project D. Please pause this video and try to figure out the right answer. I hope you are ready with your answer. Let's look at the problem again. For each project, we have the NPV. We also have the duration for each project. Project A is for 6 months. B is for 1 year. C and D are for 2 years. NPV includes the time value of money, so we can simply ignore the information about the project duration. Duration is there just to confuse us. We will look only into the NPV. Which project has the highest NPV? NPV for project A is 100K. It is 120K for project B, 110K for project C, and 128K for project D. Project D has the highest NPV. So, our choice is D, project D. Did you get that right? Let's move to our second problem. A project requires an initial investment of $10,000 and provides a positive cash flow of $5,000 in the first year and $5,000 in second year. The rate of return for this project is 10% per annum. Which of the following statements is true? A. The NPV for the project is 0. B. The NPV for the project is $20,000. C. The NPV of the project is less than 0. D. NPV of the project is more than 0. Again, please pause the video and try it yourself. Alright, let's try to find the correct choice. There is an investment of $10,000 at the start of the project. This means that at time 0, we have net cash flow of minus 10,000. It is at time 0, so the present value will also be minus 10,000. We have positive cash flows of plus $5,000 in year 1 and year 2. Present value will be. The present value is always less than the future value because we divide the future value with a number that is more than 1 to get the present value. So, present value for both year 1 and year 2 is less than $5,000. The sum of these two is definitely less than $10,000. NPV is the sum of all present values. Time 0 is minus 10,000. The other two are less than plus 10,000. So, what will the NPV be? It has to be less than 0, a negative number. We don't have to calculate anything to reach this conclusion. Simple observation is enough. PMP exam will never involve any complex calculations. Let us pick our answer choice now. It is C. The NPV of the project is less than 0. We will move to the third problem now. There are 4 projects under consideration. Project A has IRR of 12%. Project B and Project C have IRR of 14%. And Project D has IRR of 13%. Which statement is true? A. Both Project B and Project C should be selected. B. Either Project B or Project C should be selected. C. We should select only one project. D. The desired rate of return is needed to select suitable projects. This is an interesting problem. Please pause the video and try to figure out the correct choice. Let's have another look at the choices. Choice A is Project B and Project C. These two projects have the highest IRR at 14%. But can we pick both of them? Is the IRR high enough? We don't know. Choice B is Project B or Project C. Still, we don't know if the IRR is good enough. Choice C. We should select only one project. Why just one? If multiple projects meet our financial objectives, we can pick more than one. But only if we have enough resources, people, money, time, etc. Our resources limit our ability to take all the viable projects. Choice D. The desired rate of return is needed. Yes, we need this information to judge whether the IRR is good enough. If our target is 15%, none of these can be selected. If it is 10%, we can potentially select all these 4 projects with B and C at the top of our priority. So, our choice is D.